So here's what I think the best answer is. The best possibility is that we do have a mathematical proof that follows standard rules of deduction that shows that the cipher is secure. And there are very few ciphers that we can actually get that for. One actually is the one-time pad, and we'll see that later this unit, how to prove in a mathematical sense that it has a very strong security property. The next best one is the last one, which is to show in a formal way why this cipher is at least as hard as some other problem. And we'll talk about reduction proofs more later in this course. The basic premise here is that there's some other problem that we have good reasons to believe is always already hard. And then we're going to show that if we could break the cipher, we could solve that other problem that we already have good reasons to believe is hard. The next best is this one that many smart, highly motivated people tried to break it but couldn't. This is often the best we can do. And for the best symmetric ciphers that are in use today, this is really the reason that they're argued secure. There may be formal arguments that show why they resist particular attacks, and that's part of smart people trying to break ciphers, is knowing all the known best case attacks and trying them against the cipher and seeing that the cipher resists them. But ultimately, the best we can do is show that, well, we think it's secure because it has these properties and lots of smart people weren't able to break it. But that's not a very satisfying way to know it's secure. We'd certainly much rather have the strong mathematical proof. The worst possible argument here is the key space argument. And this one is often made incorrectly. The number of keys gives you an upper bound on the difficulty to break the cipher, because at worst, the attacker could try all the keys. That's not true for the one-time pad, as we saw. Trying keys gives you perfectly sensible messages that you'll eventually see all possible messages, so you can't know which key is correct. But for ciphers where the key space is smaller than the message space, you could try keys and have a good likelihood, if the key leads to a sensible message, that that's the right message. So this gives you an upper bound on how hard it is to break a cipher. It doesn't give you a lower bound. The fact that you have a large number of possible keys doesn't mean the cipher is secure. We can always add to the key space without increasing the difficulty in breaking a cipher. So we'll see many ciphers with very large key spaces that are completely insecure. So our best possible argument is to have a mathematical proof. And that's what Claude Shannon was able to do for the one-time pad. And it's really a fairly unusual case where we can get a mathematical proof that's that strong.